I know, it's a bit early to be calling anything anime of the year, but every once in a while there comes along a series that absolutely deserves at least a nomination. To Your Eternity has a very unique premise and one of the most captivating plots I've ever experienced. Not to mention its first episode was one of the best first episodes in anime history. That's not an exaggeration, by the way, it's physically impossible to drop this series. You can try it yourself if you want, the drop button will literally push your cursor away with a gravitational force. That's how good it is. The first 20 seconds of episode 1 is a mysterious introduction narrated by someone with as much enthusiasm as Heartseed from Kokoro Connect, who I assume is some kind of omnipotent being or god. His goal is just to observe the main character, who is a, well, he's a lot of things, but in the beginning he's just a ping pong ball. The twist is that he's got the ability to transform into the things around him. So after he gets sent to Earth, he changes into a rock, and then moss, and eventually a doge. Also, yes, he was transported to another world, but I personally think it would be insulting to label this an isekai. Anyway, after our main character experiences consciousness for the first time ever, he starts testing out the mechanics of a doggo and gradually replicates its behaviors as well. He quickly learns how to walk, eat, piss, cum, and shit, and eventually returns to his owner's house, which is where this episode starts to get a bit sad. You see, the boy had no idea his actual dog got injured and died months ago. He's extremely happy to reunite with what he thinks is his best friend, but doesn't know the dog's patch notes have been updated. This new version is immortal. Although it still feels pain, all its injuries are automatically healed within 20 seconds and it can't die. My first impressions of this anime was that it felt a lot like that movie The Thing, if The Thing wasn't trying to kill everyone and was just kind of vibing instead. This dog is harmless, he has no desire to kill or conquer, his only purpose is to exist. I'm gonna get philosophical in a bit, but anyway, there's a surprising amount of world building, even though the setting changes completely after this episode. Apparently, the boy and his dog were the last members of what used to be a community after everyone else left to search for this new land rumored to have plenty of food and people. I find it funny that the boy implies he's never seen a fruit before because of what happens in the following episode, but the boy and his dog venture off in hopes of finding that new land, and he's very optimistic, full of hope and excitement. Until he gets injured. Yeah, that was the moment every viewer got hit with a wall of dread, because at that point I think we all realized what was going to happen, making the rest of the episode emotionally painful to watch as the boy's positivity slowly drains out of him and he begins accepting the inevitable. The best indicator of a good anime are the emotions felt by the person watching it, so the fact that this first episode made me cry is a testament to the quality of the series. And by the way, please let me know if anyone else cried, I would hate to be alone there, but either way, you can't deny how incredible that episode was. My interpretation of this anime might be a bit deeper than my typical analysis videos, but the boy's death and his final request for the dog to never forget him kinda led me to appreciate a notable philosophical implication which I'll talk about in a second. But basically, not to spoil too much beyond the first episode, the dog takes on the form of the boy, essentially immortalizing him physically as well as in memory, and thus begins this beautiful journey of discovering what it means to be human. It's only just started, but it's already an amazing adventure, and I imagine he'll eventually start developing complex emotions and even forming relationships too. As for now though, he's still got a lot to learn. This little girl named March tries to teach him how to eat like a human, but because he's so used to being a dog, he basically just shoves his entire face into his food like I do to Elsa's chest in my dreams. The significance of all that is how the immortal protagonist, just like us, is the product of his environment, shaped by everyone around him. However, because he's immortal and very powerful, that's extremely dangerous. This anime has bad guys who try to torture him, which could have easily given him the impression that all humans are a threat. Think about what it would mean for humanity if an immortal being deemed us a threat. I think this would be a totally different anime if that was the case. But luckily, during his very first encounters with humanity, our protagonist was treated with love and kindness. March and the boy from episode 1 were both essential characters who may have literally saved the world just by showing our protagonist the good sides of humanity. But while the protagonist is immortal in a literal sense, we are as well because our actions also affect everything around us. Whether you're aware of it or not, every decision you make has a permanent impact on the future. Every time you smile at someone, every time you say good morning, every time you're toxic in a league game, and every time you hit the like button, you're always influencing people, even if only a little bit. And every person you influence will go on to influence others, and that cycle continues forever, long after you and I are both dead. That's what our eternity is. the protagonist of this anime is just the author's way of visualizing it. I didn't mean for this video to turn into a life lesson, but I think the takeaway is to always be a good person because your legacy is forever and that's what immortalizes you. This anime is dope, the art and music are great, and I'm not gonna spoil it, but episode 5 was surprisingly almost as good as episode 1. I cried again today while rewatching it, and everyone who contributed to its production deserves some kind of award. It's just baffling that anime can be this good. I think what the series does best is convey emotions. Whether the mood is happy or sad, this anime uses the transitive property to flawlessly channel those exact emotions onto us, the viewers. If the author wants us to laugh, we're gonna laugh. If he wants us to cry, we're gonna cry. I've even been wearing a condom this whole time, just in case the author wants us to come. Most importantly, though, there's not a second this anime didn't have my full attention even during the slower parts, and watching this feels like my ADHD has been cured. There's not really any filler, but the occasional slice of life moments are just as interesting as the action, and that's a pretty substantial accomplishment. This might sound like a strange concept, but To Your Eternity is occasionally so good that it ruins my immersion. You know, it's nice to be completely immersed into a fantasy world to the point that you forget you're even watching an anime. However, the next level of that is when it's just so good you have to take a step back and admire it as a form of art. Of course, at the time of recording this, there's only been 5 episodes, meaning there's still plenty of time for this anime to get bad. I'm definitely jumping the gun by calling it a contender for anime of the year, but I don't give a fuck. If the rest of the season upholds the same quality of these first 5 episodes, then it absolutely deserves a nomination. I hope I convinced someone to start watching this show, and if I did, or if you're already watching it, please let me know what you think in the comment section. I didn't want this video to go too long though, because Hyacinth Reviews is doing the editing for me. He's another YouTuber who is a much better editor than I am, so shout out to him for helping me out. His channel link is in the description if you want to check out his content. He puts a lot of effort into his videos, so I would highly recommend subscribing. I'm out for now though, keep talking about To Your Eternity. Peace out.